Hey, and welcome back to another episode of I Was Lazy and Now I Only Have 4 Hours to Make and Post This Sunday's Episode. It is I, your host Celso, accompanied as always by your co-host Shed. You guys might be wondering, Celso, why are you dressed like you're Russian? And to that, I only have to say, Я вышла на прогулку. Я тот наряд очень удобный. So, as you probably saw by the video's title, today we're going to be talking about how to be healthy in an unhealthy family. And this can be quite tricky, you know. My first advice, if you can accomplish it, would be for you to go on a quest worldwide to just annihilate all the junk food, you know, just burn all of it, you know, go to factories, go to everywhere in the world and just kill all junk food. Then your family will have no other choice other than be healthy. And by default, also you. But this can be a little bit tricky if you don't have the right amount of firepower and power and money and straight up impossible. So I'm going to give you some other options. And you can take what suits you best from the three tips that I'm going to give you next. Okay, so the first advice would be for you to go like, Pa, come on, cut the pizza. No more pizza, bro. Give me the broccoli and the chicken breast and the rice, you know? Just go with that. No more of that pizza stuff. Nah, for real, no. Basically that. But you would talk to your family and you'd be like, okay, guys, I really want to be healthier. Can you please just make me healthier options for dinner? Or you can allow me to cook my own stuff, you buy me what I ask you to buy me, and I cook it myself. It would be okay if you guys can do it, please. And you basically just talk to your family. But the thing is, this can be really tricky. If you can accomplish that and your family is really supportive, even though they are not as healthy themselves, this would be golden. But the thing is, you know, it's not going to be that easy. Because even if your family is all up for it, you know, there can be times when you are having your broccoli and your rice and whatever, just healthy stuff, low calorie stuff, but your family will not be accompanying you most of the time, and they will be having pizza and all the good stuff. And you will start to falter. You need to understand, unless you have a natural willpower and discipline, you will start to falter. Not in the beginning, because in the beginning you have so much motivation, you know, you are you against the world and you're going to change your life. But that's the thing, that's the beginning. We're looking for you not to make a diet, but to make a long-term change to your life, to really just change your life. And it can really start to get difficult in the medium to long term if you are eating healthy and you have all these snacks around you. You have all this bad stuff around you, you will cave in. And it can be really easy to regress to your unhealthy lifestyle if you have so much unhealthy stuff around you, you know? And this is the best case scenario where your family is fully supportive of you. Because sometimes your family will not be supportive of it. Sometimes, very contrary to what people would think, parents can just be like, don't do any dieting, you are perfect the way you are, why are you trying to change? And they can do this because, well, people are just naturally afraid of change. They don't see the need for you to change. Why are you trying to change, you know? Maybe you are taking action and it reflects on them that they are not, you know? It shines on their insecurity. And if their child can just be strong and try to have a healthier lifestyle, why cannot they? So instead of accompanying you, some people will just try to change your mind and to just keep you unhealthy, just like them, so that everyone can be unhealthy and happy together, you know what I mean? It is not pleasant to hear, but it can happen. So, if this works for you, that's great, but it's really tricky to make this work. Okay, guys, so the second tip will be for you to save most of your calories for dinner. And why is this? Well, basically, I am thinking for most families, they would probably be like my family. And what happens is, most families just really get together for one meal of the day, which is dinner. Why is this? I mean, everyone, it doesn't matter if you're studying, if you are working, You need to get out of the house early in the morning, and then you go during the morning and evening. You are either studying or you are working. And when everyone gets really together is at dinner, you know, because everyone is home. It doesn't matter if you work or if you study. That's the thing. When everyone gets together, if your family is unhealthy, they will eat unhealthy stuff. And if you save most of your calories for the dinner, and you eat low-calorie dense foods throughout the day, you can really just get away with having an unhealthy dinner better. This is not perfect, this is not ideal, but this is better than just eating unhealthy all day long. At least when you are outside of the house, you have some control over what you eat. Actually, scratch that, you have all the control over everything you eat. You can prepare your own snacks, your own food to eat outside of the house. While you are having dinner, not as much. You are not the person cooking most of the time, and even if you are, what we discussed in point number one. So try to take advantage of all the time you have away from your house. Third and last tip that I'm going to give you guys is just move out and start living alone. And okay, I know that this will sound really bad to some of you. This is by far the hardest of all the three tips that I gave you to implement, because some of you are just not financially independent enough to move out of the house. Some of you, most of you I hope, just love your family and you don't want to be away from them and move house so early. I understand that. The thing is, if you have an unhealthy family, unfortunately, I would say that this is only the only real way for you to have a completely healthy lifestyle. Because when you are alone, you won't have all those temptations, because you can just be like, I'm not going to buy anything that's unhealthy for the house, so that when I want to eat something unhealthy, I have to physically move out of the house and go get it, and it's another detriment for me to eat something unhealthy compared to just having a bag of chips sitting in your basement and you just get up from your couch, go to the basement, get some chips. I don't think the basement is where you put your chips, but I don't know you. You can be a freak, you know? You probably are a freak, yeah? Okay, really now. You guys understand what I'm saying, yeah? If you are not around bad influences, you know, when it comes to eating healthy, you will be able to maintain your healthy lifestyle for way longer. So, unfortunately, the best way for you to have a healthy lifestyle, if you have an unhealthy family, is to just get out of the house. Okay, guys, and this is all. I hope you guys found this entertaining or helpful, or hopefully both. If you guys like this, you already know what to do. You have to make that sweet, sweet love to that like button. And then, because you are a very, very bad person, you're going to shit on that like button with the subscribe button. Yeah. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace!